pile of scrap.
What? I'm going to do a small project. So it's 3.2 meter wooden dinghy or a wooden boat. No fiberglassing, no epoxy, it's just gonna be a wooden boat. But they did it back in the day. There's no lighting in here, so it's not gonna show nicely on the video, but some hand tools, scrap wood, nails, permanent wood glue or water. Proof wood glue, that's the one that's in the picture, but I'm also using water resistant glue, or I'm going to use it in areas where you don't anticipate the water to get at. So it's basically a 50 millimeter frame or a 2-inch frame, horizontal frame that it's mounted on, and just tacked together with some nails. And then the frames are bolt like these ones here. This was bolt on the table, yeah, where there's now a big mess of tools and screwdrivers. But you can see on the table there's some pencil lines that I drew. So I basically took the profile of what I want, and if I was going to make a mono hull, then I would have used these two frames here, and that would have gone on the bow end. So that would have come in the front here, with this two that we're seeing now, they would have been two back, and those two will come in the front, and then we can add a bow piece. Oh, can't see through the camera, right about here, the arch. But now this is not going to be a V, deep V, this is going to be a flat bottom, so it's got a stump nose and a transom. Basically looks like the bow is going to look, but the bow is more steep and a little bit narrower. But that's part one, and hopefully I get a chance to make some more of the stuff that's gonna happen here. And here's a bee boxes, guys. I'm permanently into beekeeping now for a hobby. It's not a commercial act, but it's not really part of the boat building. But here's the little bee escape that I built to let the bees out from the super. Now you know the super is a smaller container where you get your honey out. Okay, so that's just for the, I just saw it here and I thought I'll put it in here. Maybe you're interested in beekeeping as well. So that there's a deep and three supers, and then we've got the bee, proper beehives on the outside which the bees are in. This is just spares, because you never know when you're gonna need them. That's beekeeping. Okay, so 3.2 meter, don't know what that's in feet. It's about, what's it, more or less 3 feet in a meter. So I call it 10 foot, something like that. 10, 12 foot, somewhere in that region. I didn't work it out in the head now. And my head is full of other ideas that I've got to do the stringers. You can see all this wood that's lying here, that's going to become the stringers. And they're going to line the boat, and then on top of that we'll put the 4 millimeter plyboard, and that'll be sealed with wood sealer, and it'll get the normal yacht spa varnish that we put on top of it, and that's going to be a dinghy. Fish with it, just have a jolly ride with a small 3.5 motor. We've got the old motor here, which used to, it's all dusty, but it's like brand new. Okay, so a bit of toying around, playing with a bit of wood and a bit of glue. Let me show you the differences on the glue. For the guys that's in South Africa, they'll know, the name Ponel. And this is not water resistant, but this one is water resistant. And you can actually wet a piece of wood and it stays together. So it's really permanent, but I guess I've got to add some sort of safety factor, so they say it's water resistant. But the Pro 40P, that is the one that's water proof. It's a D4 model. Where's the name there? D4 waterproof. And it's a bastard to work with, because once it gets on your hands, you don't get it off. It's there for a couple of days. No matter how much you wash it, or you can use thinners, but it's not soluble. It won't come off. So good for bonding stuff, but not good for getting off your hands. Okay, so most probably by the weekend I might have done something else, and then I'll do a short video and maybe get some better lighting here, because at this time of day it's fairly dark in here. I didn't put the lights on. I don't think it's going to make a difference. Let's see. So little frames is 50 by 16s. So now I've doubled up on that and made it a bit more stronger. I can shave off and screw and, you know, go crazy when it's a bit thicker. So it's all little pieces of wood that's just being used, rather than going and spending money on brand new pieces of wood. So if you do that, it'll cost you roughly $1,500 for the wood. Now if you're doing this just for a simple dinghy, it's going to last probably 3-4 years, and then the sun's going to get the better of it and the salt water. Don't waste money, just use little scraps you've got. I won't be stingy on the ply board, but the interior or the framing, that can be scraps of wood that's glued together and finished off and made look nice, and you put the deck on the inside, you're not even going to see it. So as long as those cracks, the wood's got to be solid, you know. It can be scrap wood, but not in the sense of rubbish, so that will tear apart or frot, what do you call it, wood that really has seen its days. Where this wood is perfectly fine, it's best used in other projects at the wood factory where I picked it up. So even the back piece of ply there, that was a scrap piece of ply that they threw away, because the backside had a problem with it, and I just cut it out. I don't think you can even see it. It's still, there's a little bit of a crack line showing here, but that's getting covered. There's another board going over that, so that's not going to hurt us at all. It's just on the outer layer anyway, so it's not the, this is 18 millimeter thickness, and this is 3.5 horsepower motor that's going on here. So I'm just gonna go the Kiesway, keep it stupid simple. That's it, boys.